Alright guys, I'm really excited about doing this review. I have a new product for the micro FPV world that really hasn't been changed very much since, you know, since I can remember. And it's two brands we already know of, Gemfan and HQ. Looks like they're getting into the micro prop game. Well, let's see how they did. All right, so let's take a little bit of a closer look at these HQ props. Get them out of the bag here. All right, this is what's kind of cool about these guys. They look like HQ props. I mean, they look like they're just shrunken down HQ quad blade props, which is pretty neat coming, you know, coming from a 5-inch background and knowing what HQ props looks like. It finally feels like somebody is getting into, somebody that knows what they're doing is kind of taking a whack at this. So what I'm noticing is a smaller hub in the center with, actually, it connects at a smaller joint to the hub as well. We'll see as far as durability goes later, but they are made of ABS, and it looks like there's a hole in the very top, which is kind of interesting. I wonder if you can mount these guys and turn them opposite direction to fly them. Anyways, so let's check the weight on them. So for the HQ quad, we're looking at 0.8 grams. All right, guys, now let's take a look at the Gemfans. Now, this is something really interesting. Looks like Gemfans actually packaging two sets in one package. Different, I'm not against it. That might be the difference in pricing. I'm going to put the prices right down at the bottom at some point so you can also compare the pricing as well. All right. So the cool thing about these guys is it does also looks like a Gemfan prop. I'm digging how they kind of kept the nostalgia of the big prop and just kind of put it in this tiny, tiny package. Looks like they've made some different choices here, though. They have picked a different material. This one actually feels a little bit more stiff and like it might be a little bit more durable than the ABS. Instead of a cone-shaped small hub, they've decided on something that's about, it looks to be about the same size as the motor. So I would say that's probably about a 6mm flat top, and also have decided to connect it with a bigger portion at the hub. So that's pretty much what I can just tell by looking at it. So let's put these guys on the scale. All right. So we're looking at about 1.2 grams, which you can see is a little bit heavier than the HQ prop, which is to be expected based off of their material and just how you can see how they've designed the prop. All right, so let's take a look at these guys. These are what we're really comparing them to. These are what I've been running and what I would say most Tiny Whoop pilots have been running. Fresh off the Invitational, these are the props everybody was running. So I will say some things about these guys. I've got a lot of packs through them, and they do this kind of like you bent your nail back, and then it bends back, and it's got a crease in it. They tend to do that. You can probably see it just a little bit right there at the hub. They tend to do that when you crash into walls and such. The material is just not great. But this has been what we have, what's kind of been the staple prop for us for a long time. So obviously we got to compare it to these guys, because if they're not any better, then who cares? So looking like it's settling at 1 gram. So it's going to land right between our HQ and our Gemfan as far as weight goes. Now, I'm not really that big of a fan of the tri-blades, but I have them here in front of me, so we're going to test them right alongside of them. And maybe, who knows, they could change my mind. So let's find 4 here. So we'll put that at 1.1. 1.1 grams. For a tri-blade. All right, guys, so what I've done here is I've weighed my Tiny Whoop racer. Now, this guy is loaded up with the Awesome Sauce motors, 20,000 kV, pretty standard 6 by 17 millimeter motor. It's a a lot of people love this motor. It's widely run, so I'm really not doing anything different here. Running it on my TWR. So just this guy without props weighs 21.1 grams. Now, what I've done here is I've added that weight to the weight of four props. So this is our total aircraft weight all the way over here with each of these props on top of this guy. All right, what I've done from there is calculate how much of that weight is taken up by our prop. So we're looking at right here, the Yixing quad blade at 1 gram takes up 4.74% of the total craft weight. Now this is without battery, of course, so I'll be running the same battery on all of them. All right, and then the HQ is the lightest, of course, so it should make up, as it does, the lowest percentage of craft weight. So 3.65 there. Gemfan quad blade at 1.2 grams makes up 5.38% of the craft weight, and the tri-blade makes up 4.95% of the craft weight. The reason I do it this way is because it's all relative to this little guy. He doesn't weigh very much, so any kind of changes, even as minuscule as this, could make a difference. Now we got all that boring stuff out of the way. What we're gonna do is we're gonna fly these things. So I got two more parts of this review to go. First off, we're gonna do feel and fly. So I'm gonna start off with my Yixing blades, the thing that I've been flying with forever, and I'm gonna do exactly 10 packs on each set, one after the other, and then at the end, I'm gonna go back through each of them, do a couple of packs on each of them on a given track, same track, and then hopefully at the end, kind of get that feel, what I think I like the best as far as feel goes. Now I know that's super subjective, so that part is all just my opinion. But enough freaking talk. Let's fly these things. We'll do a quick track fly through here. Try to design this track to kind of showcase different aspects of Tiny Whoop Racing. First section here, got some tight hairpins into a long sweeper. To an extremely tight section underneath the table here. Up the ladder, either side, gonna practice both. Then we got this chain gap. Through the high speed section, pylon, this direction around this guy. Down through here, and that's one lap. So let's do some testing. So one more test. We're going to do a durability test now. What I've done is I've taken an older frame of mine, and I've actually used a metal file and filed down the very front of the front two ducts, so they're nice and squishy now. So I'm trying to simulate an older frame, so maybe we can get some hits on those props and see how durability goes. So cue the slow motion footage. So, for the verdict, first things first, let's talk about the Yixing prop. It was my baseline for all my testing because it's the prop that I've flown for quite a while. I can say now that I won't be flying this prop anymore because both the HQ and the Gemfan, in my opinion, outperformed the Yixing prop in every single way. So, bye-bye, Yixing. Kind of done with you, buddy. All right, now let's talk about these two guys. Let's talk about the HQ and the Gemfan. Now, as far as the look of these props, I love how the prop looks. They look like the little brother of the 5-inch prop. Looks like an HQ, looks like a Gemfan. Some people think it looks like an Azure, but whatever. I think it looks like a Gemfan. I'm on board with it. So the one tiny complaint that I have is HQ's color selection's kind of lame, and I'm really digging the clear props that that Gemfan came out with. And also, they have a full lineup, so it's pretty cool to be able to have all your quads with these little guys on them. So. As far as price goes, now the price of these, they are packaged differently, so you have to take that in consideration. A package of two full sets, so that's eight props of the Gemfan, runs $4.99. I'm getting that price from Pyro. And then the HQ for one set costs $2.29. So the HQ is just a hair less expensive, but it's so little, you know, whatever. Not that big of a deal. Don't think it's a factor because these guys are durable. So as you saw, crashed it a ton, did my best to simulate something that would cause a prop issue, and they are both durable. Had no issues whatsoever, whereas the Yixing probably would have been wadded up, or like I said before, looked like you bent your fingernail back and then you got to smooth it back out. So I will say that both of them passed that with flying colors. Now there was a pretty big difference in weight. The HQ for one set, four props, comes in 0.4 grams lighter than the Gemfan. I honestly thought that was going to make a bigger difference when it comes to the performance. I thought that the HQ was going to have a lot better spin up, better top end, that kind of thing. Just kind of was my predictions. But to be completely honest, I didn't feel a whole lot of a difference in the top end of both of these props. They both feel great on the top end. And they both feel great in tight areas, like going under the table, like you saw real quick, in and out. They both do great in there. But I think for me, the Gemfan edges out just a little, and I'll tell you why. The Gemfan, I felt like I had better elevation control. I felt like the quad was actually a little better locked in exactly where I want it to be with this guy. It's so minimal, to be completely honest. It's so minimal, both great props, but I think the Gemfan's what I'm gonna go with. I also like the hub design that they've gone with. They did go with it's a little bigger, but it's flat on top. Makes it super easy to put these guys, and you're not bending shafts and stuff like that on those little bitty motors. And also, I think only time's gonna tell on this one, but the material that it's made, that the prop is made out of, I think it's gonna hold up better for the actual inside the hub. So where the motor shaft goes into the prop, I think that is gonna last a little longer. Because you know, sometimes you'll get a hot motor or something like that, and come to find out your prop's just, it's not spinning. The motor's spinning in the prop. So I think that's gonna be like, hoping that's a thing of the past. So anyways. Gemfan for me, that's what it's kind of looking like, but hope you enjoyed it. Hope you got some information out of this, but thanks for watching, guys. Later.